I've been making some heart bowls for a while, and I thought I'd extend upon that concept and turn it into a jewelry box. I started a fresh new project in Fusion 360 and designed a more organic shape with my signature epoxy line going through the middle. I figured this would be easy to make, but I had several problems I encountered and I had to solve them along the way, including breaking an expensive bit. My normal process is to glue up several pieces of cherry wood until it precisely measures 2.5 inches thick for the box. I could then machine the epoxy mold directly into the wood. I generally use a spiral down-cutting bit to get a good finish on the bottom of the workpiece and avoid chip-out. The bumpy pattern in the wood is what leaves the drippy-like look in the finished box. I repeated the process using a 3/4-inch piece of wood for the lid. My shop is pretty cold, around 58 Fahrenheit, so I pre-warmed the epoxy in some 80 Fahrenheit water and used a space heater on a temp switch to keep the workpiece warm while the epoxy cured. The epoxy stuck to cure at around 70 to 75 Fahrenheit. The first epoxy step was to seal the wood with a thin coat of quick-setting epoxy. I mixed up and tinted the epoxy, poured it into the wood area, and let most of it drain out. I even used a heat gun to help the epoxy flow a little faster. I did this in order to not have layers show up in the final workpiece. However, I don't think it's always necessary to seal the wood, and I stopped doing it in some later pieces. Specifically, less porous hardwoods that are fully dry don't need to be sealed. The main epoxy pour was a deep pour epoxy, and I tinted it with Bora Bora Blue from Black Diamond Pigments. I generally overpour the piece a bit and use some silicone sealant to keep it all in. Once the epoxy cured, I could plane it back down to the original 2.5-inch height. Then it was back to the CNC machine, where I used the blue tape and CA glue technique to hold down the workpiece. This was required so I could machine the entire workpiece without hitting a clamp. I machined the outside of the box and popped off the table. Notice that the glue is what separated when I pulled the two pieces apart instead of the tape ripping apart. I tested this with the lid before I machined it, and the same thing happened. This is foreshadowing an upcoming problem. I machined the lid in the same way as the box bottom, but I decided to do the inside of the lid first. This also had some issues due to my tool pass, which will come up shortly. I realized that my general CA gluing process was flawed. It would work sometimes, but not all the time. I'd put a bunch of glue on the workpiece, use some accelerator on the other side, and squish them together by hand for a few seconds. I had also tossed on a heavy weight to help pull it together. My CA glue is probably a few years old, and it really only has a shelf life of about 1 year, but the problem is the glue skinning up before it adheres to the part. I'll show how I solve this in a bit, but first the big problem. I glued the workpiece to a scrap piece of plywood in order to indicate in the origin of the box. This alignment is critical for getting the second operation to precisely match up with the first operation. Once I started machining the workpiece, it started chattering a ton. I stopped the machine, grabbed the piece, and it just popped off in my hands. I decided to temporarily solve this problem by using some 5-minute epoxy. I let it cure for a full hour and then proceeded with the machining. The alignment was a bit off, but it wasn't too bad, and I didn't get any more chatter. My solution for the CA glue problem was to clamp the pieces together and let the CA glue cure for 5 minutes under pressure. Once I started doing this, the glue was no longer the failure point and the tape would rip away. It was much stronger, and I think it entirely solved my problem. I used this new CA glue and tape method to attach the lid to a scrap piece of wood and indicated it in. On one box I put on my table and another I put in a vise. Both techniques worked fine. Once I had finished all the machining, I did a test fit of the lid. This was my next issue. The lid was way too tight, probably because I didn't design in any tolerance. The solution for my prototype piece was to just grind it away and make it fit. This worked, but I got a few nicks on the underside of the lip of the lid. When I did a second box, I decided to inset the lid by about 25 thousandths of an inch to get a better fit, and this worked pretty well. I really like using Osmo top oil for my bowls and boxes. It's super easy to apply, fairly durable, and leaves a nice satin finish. In the end, my prototype box turned out awesome. However, there's always room for improvement, and I decided to lighten the lid a bit more, make the grip a bit bigger, and make the walls of the box a bit thinner to make it a little more petite. The second one was made out of cherry with purple tinted epoxy. If you want to learn how to make these, then consider buying my complete guide on how to make the heart bolt. The link is in the description. I include the Fusion 360 file with all my machining tool paths, and I also export the models as STLs in case you don't use Fusion. I also have a step-by-step PDF describing everything you need to do to make the bowl. Comment below if you want me to release the heart box in the same manner, and that way you could make one of them for yourself on your own CNC machine. Thanks, everyone.